G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this week's video. The topic this week is 10 frames and specifically 10 frame flashcards. So I've been doing the videos for 12 months now, over 12 months, and every week the video has been accompanied by a set of worksheets for students to practice various skills. This week, for the first time, there are no worksheets, but there are flashcards instead. So they come from this book, which is a fairly new book, 10 Frame Flashcards, for grades K to 1, or prep to 1 if you're in a country that has prep. And it's for helping students to develop familiarity with the patterns of the numbers from 0 to 10. The book actually goes beyond that, so there are later sets that go up to 20, and there's a variety of other ways of using the 10 frame flashcards. So what we're looking at, I just want to cover briefly what 10 frames are useful for. If you've watched many of my videos, a couple of weeks ago I mentioned 10 frames again, so they come up quite often in my videos because they are such a good resource. So I make no apologies for talking about them a lot, because I really think that in every early years classroom, students should have ready access to 10 frames. I'd recommend every child has their own 10 frame and their own counters. And when they're ready for the numbers beyond 10 up to 20, they would have double 10 frames, and that they would be used almost every day. So they're used for studying numbers, and they're used for studying number facts, and just developing a really solid foundation in the basic numbers. All right, so the idea of a 10 frame is that students can recognize a representation for a number, realizing, of course, that numbers are abstract ideas, so this is not a number. We mustn't think that this is the number, or that the counters are the number. The number is an idea. So we grow up learning about numbers, and we gradually develop this idea of something you can think about and understand, which is a number. It's very hard to actually put it into words. I'm not going to go too far down that track, but we need to realize that this is a representation, and that's all. All right. The beauty of this is that because there are 10 squares on a 10 frame, and that, of course, is because our number system is based on the number 10, we can see how many there are by comparing the number of counters with the full frame, or the complete frame. So we can, up to 4 or 5, it's not too bad. It's not too difficult to subitize a number anyway and say, well, that's 4 because I can see 2 rows of 2 and that sort of thing. But with the larger ones, we get to see how many there are simply because there's a certain number of gaps. Anyway, so this is the number 4. And when the students are just beginning to learn their numbers and learn their representations and the symbols and that sort of thing, early in their school life, they may very well have to count the counters. But we will encourage them not to need to count. So the point of using the 10 frames is to provide them with a set of mental models or visual models that they can, with practice, immediately recognize. So that when they're older, we can show them larger numbers like 8 and 7 and 9 and so on. And they'll be able to glance at the 10 frame and go, I know what that number is. Now, I will just talk a little bit about the different, there are two different ways of representing numbers using 10 frames. And I'll illustrate that with the book. The first way, which I'm showing here on the board and is represented in the accompanying sheets that go with this video, we start off by counting in pairs. So we put 2 as a pair of counters, both at one end. And then 3, there's one more. So we're showing odd and even numbers. In the book, we've used red counters for all of these so that the teacher can recognize which sort they are. So this is one recommended way, and we think it's the easier way of the two that I'll show you. So you can see we've got 4 is an even number, 5 is an odd number, 6 is even, 7 is odd. So it's a really nice way of showing even and odd numbers. Beyond that, and these are not included in the free set today with the video, we have this arrangement. So, and we've used a different color, as you can see. So we've used purple. This time we extend along one row for 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 5, of course, fills the row. And then we start on the second row. So this is based, if you like, on a 5s pattern. So we fill up the first 5 and then we fill up the second 5. Both sets both ways of arranging the counters and using them to show numbers have their benefits. They both show different aspects of the numbers. Okay, so when we show a number, so let me put a different number up here. So let's look at the number 6, represented by those 6 counters on the 10 frame. We will want to talk to our students about what we can see about the number 6. Tell me about the number 6. Well, we can see that it's made up of 3 and 3 more. We can see it's made of 2 and 2 and 2. We can see it makes a nice little neat rectangle because it's an even number. The rows are even. It's an even number. We can see that there are 4 empty spaces. So if we had another 4 counters, we could make this up to 10. If we rearrange them like so, as I just said, this is another way of arranging the counters, we can see that 6 is also made of 5 and 1 more. We can see it's a little bit more than half of the 10 frame, and so on and so on. So there are lots of discussions that you can have. You could ask students to make up stories about just one number. Make up stories about the number 6. Write down as many stories as you know, just using symbols. And it's worth mentioning at this point that in the early years, we're not asking the students to memorize their number facts, and yet some number facts are going to be really easy to see. So although we're not requiring them to know that 5 plus 1 is 6, looking at an arrangement like that, we could say, can you see how many are in the top row? How many are in the bottom row? What is 5 and 1 more? So we will still talk about those basic number facts. All right. So using the cards, what I recommend you do is to simply cut all the cards in half so that you've got a stack. There'll be 11 cards showing the numbers represented from 0 to 10. Mix them up, so shuffle them, and then simply show them to your child, your students, one at a time. And the idea is that we want the students to recognize them as quickly as possible. So it's not some sort of magical trick. It's not some sort of, you know, freaky exercise in impressing parents or something. You know, it's not for some sort of party trick, but it's to be able to recognize the patterns so that we can use them for mathematics in the future. All right, so really useful activity, something that I think the students will find fun to do, and as I said, setting in place some really good foundations. So that's it for this week. I look forward to talking to you next time.